Hey guys, we're Evan and Caitlin, and today we're gonna 3D print with lasers.
We've had a lot of fun in the past using 3D printers to make silicone molds.
Things going as planned!
But the part that's least fun is the priming and sanding and priming and sand and prime sand, prime sand, prime sand, prime sand. We want to avoid that.
So we have another 3D printed silicone mold we're gonna make for a different project, and we purposely made this design a lot more complex so that we couldn't really easily sand it by hand.
Which kind of forces us to figure out SLA printing, which uses a laser and resin to make prints so smooth they shouldn't need too much sanding.
But we've never done this before, so hopefully we can figure out how to use this new technology and different finishing techniques so we end up with a castable print and not a pile of goo.
Thank you, Matter Hackers, for sponsoring this video.
So first up is we're gonna print this design using fused filament fabrication, which is what we normally do, and PLA because it's a lot cheaper.
So this is the first prototype. We're gonna go ahead and go through all of the prototypes here on the TAS 6 before we move over to the Moai and do some lasering. You can see the layer lines present on this print right here.
That's what we have to sand and prime and sand and prime. So we're gonna be avoiding that when we do the next print. But for now, test fit. Oops. I guess we haven't actually explained what we're making. We'll go into it more in the next video where we actually make this thing, but this is a candle holder that is supposed to hold two different types of candles. So we want to make sure that the design works. Oh, hey, it does work.
Nice.
I'm assuming if this one works, this one does. Yeah, look at that.
Wow, that looks really cool.
This design works, so now we can move forward with the SLA. Before we do, should we explain what SLA is a little bit?
Stereolithography, so you basically have a vat of resin, and that resin is UV curable. And then you have a laser, a UV laser, that shoots up into this bin of resin. I'm so good at explaining things. And this laser very precisely cures bits of the resin, and then it builds it up.
Yeah.
Into a print. All right, so we have the model all done. We have it scaled by half because we want to save on resin on this first print while we're testing things. Here it goes!
There it goes!
Lasers will be happening soon.
Good luck.
Lasers!
Trying to show you what's going on in there. There you go. You can kind of see it. Yeah, so that's the print bed. It prints upside down and raises up layer by layer. And there's a little laser going.
Alrighty. While that goes, we are actually going to make a curing box for this so that we can...
cure it. Okay, so resin prints cure with UV light, so you can just put them in the sun to cure, but we're not that patient, so we're gonna build a UV box instead.
So to make that, you need a box.
Foil.
UV light.
Spray adhesive.
And we're gonna go really fancy with a little solar-powered turntable. So cool looking. It's so tiny and delicate.
There's cat hair.
First print, super successful. It looks great. It is goopy though, from the resin it just came from. So we're gonna try two different methods to clean this up before curing it. One, we're just gonna put it in a jar of alcohol and then water and shake it all around. And then to get fancier, we're also gonna use an ultrasonic cleaner and then see what difference that makes. Stuck.
Okay. Oh.
It feels better? Feels like it's off?
Feels a lot better. When I first took it out, it was like super slimy, and now it feels kind of matte. So I think it's good. Now it's time to cure it fully and see how it did. Time to get fancy?
Time to get fancy. This is our turntable. So tiny.
Okay, this is supposed to be solar powered, so we're gonna see if this works.
Ta-da! Oh, wait. That's so pretty. It's so pretty.
So beautiful.
Ah, my gosh. Alrighty, so while this cures, we want to thank Matter Hackers.
They sent us the Moai, they helped us figure out things like how to make this box, how to finish the prints, and they sponsored this video.
So if you have any 3D printing needs, definitely check them out. Second print is done. Looks good. Looks the same as the last one, which makes sense. So this one is gonna go into the ultra fancy ultrasonic vibration machine to see if it can clean it better than the first one. All right, so how this works, this sends ultrasonic vibrations into the liquid. And since we don't want alcohol in here, since this has electronics and stuff, we're gonna isolate it in this jar right here.
It smells so alcoholic.
So now the vibrations will travel through the water into this.
And the alcohol will clean it.
And let's see how this works.
This is much higher pitch than I was expecting.
It sounds like it's being electrocuted. We're gonna have to get the little handheld camera. Because you can see things shaking off of this. Alrighty, now let's rinse it off in water, and then back into alcohol one more time, and then water, and then curing time.
So this is basically the same as the two jar method. It just might end up with a better finish because it's like more consistent vibrations in the alcohol.
Well, like stronger vibrations.
I don't know, I was shaking that can pretty strong.
Ultrasonic! I don't know, the jars might work just fine. That's what we're gonna figure out.
Yeah, that's what we're testing.
My hands are so fat.
All right. Okay, now we do it again. Okay, same thing, into the jar.
Into the jar.
Okay, so now we're gonna swap the part that's in the curing station. This guy's been going for a couple hours now.
We can't like note the feel yet because we're gonna do a comparison tomorrow morning.
Yes, I'm going to pick this up without feeling the surface finish.
New one in?
Yep.
Let's do it.
Beep, boop, beep, bop. Now we wait, then we compare.
All right, so it's the next day. Everything should be ready. It's time to compare the two resin thingamagoppers.
Ultrasonic resin print, shaken not stirred resin print. They feel pretty similar.
I had a theory. Simple surfaces like this wouldn't really need it, but if you have like a lot of complex, like little holes and like tiny little things that you need to get access to, you might need it. But for something like this, just go with the shaken because it's easier and cheaper.
Yeah, okay, cool.
Winner, no wait. Winner!
I mean, really, we're all winners here because they both worked. So next we're just gonna print the full size and we'll probably go into montage mode.
Montage mode! It looks like the first layer for the intersection got stuck to this bottom plate instead of sticking here because of suction forces. So I'm gonna tilt it, add some supports, and we'll try it again. Alrighty, so here's the new design. The tilt should prevent it from getting stuck again.
See if this one worked.
Is Juvie helping?
Yes. Ooh. That looks good!
Alrighty. Ooh. Ooh.
I wanna see. Ooh.
That is success. This was really exciting, not just because of the laser and because of the printer and all of
partially
that.
Partially because of the laser.
Well, partially. I love SLA 3D printing, and I don't think that we're gonna have to stand this at all. I'm excited to use this for all sorts of upcoming projects. They make resins that are castable, that you can like pour molten liquid in, that burn off.
We're gonna use this to make a silicone mold and cast concrete in it, so that will be an upcoming video. If you have any questions, or if you have any other cool ideas of stuff we could do with these resin prints, let us know in the comments.
Also, thank you again to Matter Hackers for sponsoring this video. And if you want more, if you want our behind the scenes look about how this project went, head over to patreon.com/Evan and Caitlin, where we're gonna do the after show right now.
So see you guys there. Bye! Bye.